Hello, in this video we compare volumetrics in Blender EEVEE to cycles. What do we mean by volumetrics? We all know that we can create materials where light is being reflected on the surface, refracted while traveling through an object, scattered under the surface and absorbed. That's what makes materials look the way they do. But in CG, we also want to take care of the fact that we usually are not inside a vacuum, but have air surrounding everything. And light also gets scattered around inside the air. Sometimes this is not really noticeable, sometimes it is very prominent. Think of fog, clouds, or even dust. That's what we call volumetrics. Let's jump right into Blender 2.8 Alpha 2. Since we all have been using cycles for years now, we should probably start there to get a reference. Volumetric effects in cycles are easy to create, but heavily increase rendering times and noise in our image. Although it is possible to enable volumetrics for the entire world, I found it is usually a better idea to create a domain object that contains our air, fog, dust. It's not only easier to manage to get a certain look, it is also faster to render. In Blender 2.8, we do not need to set up volume scatter and absorption nodes anymore. We can simply use the new principled volume node in our material. This new node handles every aspect of a volumetric material for us. For this quick look at volumetrics, I will just set up a very simple scene with a volumetric domain in the middle and a single bluish spotlight inside the cube, like this. The density of the volume controls both scattering and absorption, and we can tint the fog color and even use this one node for emissive things like fire simulations. We can see that it looks very realistic when we play with the strength of the light, and when we move the camera to be inside our domain object, it looks like the entire world is submerged in this sort of fog. We can also see that we get lots of noise, which we can reduce by increasing the samples and of course by post-processing, like denoising. Although I'm generally not a big fan of denoising. If I put a monkey inside the fog, we can also see that the monkey creates, let's call it, volumetric shadow. There's much less light on the shadow side of the monkey to be scattered around, but it is not completely dark since other light rays do get scattered in that area. Here in cycles we can actually do a lot more with volumetrics, but I want to keep it very basic here because EEVEE, at least at this point in time, can't do, for example, smoke simulations yet, and I want to compare a similar feature set. Let us look at EEVEE now. Generally, to get any volumetrics we need to switch them on in the render tab. And I like to bump up the samples and set the tile size to 4 pixels to make it look much better in the viewport. For final renders, you can even set this to 2 pixels for optimum quality. This setting really slows down renders though, so you want to play around and see what looks good and performs well for your scene. In EEVEE, the lights are controlled not by emission nodes, but by separate settings, which we can adjust here. Right away, we see we have this nice beam of light from the blue spotlight, and it performs really well when I rotate the viewport. While I move the view, we can also see how EEVEE sort of fakes the illusion of light scattering by rendering those elliptical shapes and blurring things together somehow. Don't know if this will show up in the recording. The density setting on the principled volume node still has the same effect of making the fog more or less dense. Scattering and absorption settings can be tinted, and even the emission feature works. But just like with emissive meshes in EEVEE, at the moment, no light is actually emitted from it. Not even when we bake an irradiance light probe, by the way. In the current build, we also now get the volumetric shadows in EEVEE right out of the box. The effect is really very different from what we saw in cycles, but it does add a lot to the look and feel of the entire scene. In EEVEE, it might also be just much easier to not use a volumetric domain object, but instead just add volume scatter to the entire world. This way we can easily move the camera around and don't have to worry about our volumetric domain boundaries. Just like in my previous videos, I should point out that Cycles, as a ray tracing renderer, is physically much more correct than EEVEE. EEVEE uses every trick in the box to create good-looking results, but they are not physically correct. They're based on very smart visual principles game engines use to be super fast while producing as much realism as possible. Nonetheless, with a little bit of bloom effect and a second light added, we can render animations that, I think, look super nice and render very fast. This simple animation here has 300 frames and only took 15 minutes to render in full HD resolution. In Cycles with just 1000 samples, this would roughly need 16 hours on the same hardware. Here I also have a comparison where we can, like in my previous videos, see how realistic Cycles looks and how fast EEVEE is. Finally, I quickly want to go through some material setups. Volume plus surface. In EEVEE at the moment, the volume has no effect when the object has a surface. Textured volume. To see this effect at all, I had to crank up the exponential sampling to 0.97. This also works on volumetric worlds. Smoke simulation is not yet available in 2.8, so nothing to test here yet. Please also check out my other videos about EEVEE if you haven't already, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you for watching, have a great day, see you next time.